Hello, Sayen School family. Welcome to the 2020 fifth grade moving up ceremony. I am Mrs. Vassell, your principal. Let's welcome our distinguished guests of honor.
I would like to take this time to recognize the patrols for their hard work and dedication for this past school year. Whether they were helping students on the bus, crossing students safely, helping with morning announcements, or helping younger students and teachers throughout the school day, this group of fifth graders did their job in an impressive and reliable manner. They worked hard to do their share to make our school a better and safer place. Our fifth graders often gave up their recess and free time to help others in need, and we thank you for a job well done. Great job, boys and girls.
Hi, Sayen, fifth graders. I want to congratulate all of you for moving on and going over to the middle school next year after such a crazy year. It's Mr. Marr, your band teacher. I also want to take this time to acknowledge our fifth grade band members who did not get a chance to perform at our concert. It would have been this month. They did a great job all year long. I really, really wish we could have had our concert. But I do want to acknowledge the students. We have Jackson Bischoff in our percussion section. We have Charlie DiGiuseppe, one of our trombone players. Makai Hoskins-Green on trumpet. We have Abigail Kurland on flute. We have John Lowe, who plays alto saxophone. Ta-da! Juliana Manto on clarinet. And Michael Polacek, who also plays trombone. So, great job, everybody, in the fifth grade section of our band. We know all of you fifth graders will do excellent next year. So, be well. Musicians, stay sharp. Get it? And we'll see you down the road. Do great things. Bye-bye.
Hello. This year has come and gone so quickly, I can hardly believe it. I want to take a moment to congratulate the entire fifth grade class and my string students in particular. I am so incredibly proud of all that you have accomplished this year, from earning various belts and working hard on technique to gaining the next level of musicianship. All of my fifth grade string students have special characteristics that set them apart. Please congratulate them along with me at home. Abigail Kurland, who is always pushing herself to be the best violinist that she can be while also being a great comedian. Juliana Manto, who is incredibly kind and always helps her peers when they need it. Gabriel Piano, who works hard all the time and shows serious dedication. Michaela Smith, who has put in a lot of work learning violin this year and can always make me laugh. Anthony Volpicella, who has improved so much throughout this year. And Mitchell Whitman, who is very considerate and is well on his way to being a fantastic cellist. Even though I only taught you for 1 year, I can tell that each of you are going to go on to do amazing things. I am so, so proud of you and all that you have accomplished this year. I wish you the best of luck in middle school and beyond.
I'm Ms. Peck, the school counselor. I will be sharing the next few awards. This time, we will be awarding the fifth grade Student Advisory Board Awards. All students will receive a certificate for their participation this year. Student Advisory Board members were an active voice for the student body. Advisory Board members worked together with Sayen staff, developing a goal and purpose to make meaningful impacts for the good of the school and local community. Advisory Board members provided positive leadership and role modeling for others, made suggestions for activities and improvements at Sayen School, and helped to develop community service activities for our school. Congratulations and a very special thank you to our first ever Sayen School Student Advisory Board members. Our 2019-2020 Sayen Student Advisory Board members are Samuel Benchavango, Catherine Corby, Ava Ferdetta, Emily Frame, Danica Spack, and Rocco Valentino. At this time, we will be awarding the two presidential awards. All students will receive a certificate as well as a pin recognizing their achievement. I'll now be reading a letter from President Trump. There are two levels to this award. Congratulations, students, on receiving the 2020 Presidential Education Award. Mrs. Trump and I are proud to join your family, friends, and teachers in celebrating this outstanding achievement. Through hard work and perseverance in the classroom, You have earned this great honor and set your path towards an even brighter future. We commend you on this accomplishment, and we send you our best wishes for continued success as you further your education and pursue your dreams. Our Presidential Award for Educational Excellence recognizes academic success in the classroom. To be eligible, students must meet the requirements of having one exceeding score of a 5 on the state standardized test. Student award recipients must also have an academic requirement of 90% of their grades to be 3s or 4s during the first to third trimester of fourth grade, as well as first to second trimester of fifth grade. Our 2020 Presidential Award for Educational Excellence winners are Jackson Bischoff, Emily Frame, Makai Gilliam, Juliana Manto, Danica Spack, and Mitchell Whitman. Our next award is our Presidential Award for Educational Achievement. This award recognizes students that show outstanding educational growth, improvement, commitment, or intellectual development in their academic subjects, but does not meet the same criteria as the Excellence Award. To be eligible, students must meet the requirement of having all meeting scores of a 4 on the state standardized test. Student award recipients must also have an academic requirement of 90% of their grades to be 3s during the first to second trimester of fifth grade. Our 2020 Presidential Award for Educational Achievement winners are Catherine Corby, Ava Ferdetta, Abigail Curlin, John Lowe, Sydney McHale, Phoebe Moncada, Michael Paluzak, Gabriel Piano, and Rocco Valentino. Congratulations, students again, and all of your achievements and awards. And now it is time for our next speaker, Mrs. Vassell.
And now I am proud to announce the 2020 fifth grade class most improved. For Mr. Leonardo's class, Colin Gill. I'd like to read a little statement about Colin and his growth this year. Colin has worked to improve himself across all academic areas. In the beginning of the year, he struggled in math, but due to his hard work and positive attitude, he overcame many obstacles. Colin eventually became a student leader in class. Watching his confidence grow throughout the year has been amazing. We have no doubt that Colin will continue to work hard and achieve success in middle school. We are so proud of you. For Mrs. Balance class, Alexis Toth. I'd like to read a statement about Alexis. Alexis had made tremendous growth academically as well as socially. She especially has grown in the area of math this year. Her determination and daily hard work surely paid off as she gained confidence and mastered the difficult concepts in fifth grade. We are very proud of her accomplishments. Congratulations, Colin and Alexis. Congratulations on all of your wonderful accomplishments. Although this school year didn't end the way that we had hoped, we were looking forward to more games of football during recess, hatching the eggs and holding the baby chicks in your classroom, your field trips to Philadelphia and to Bizztown, your fifth grade picnic, and us being able to give you a proper goodbye as you walked the halls of Sayen one last time. You had to leave 3333 Nottingham Way much too soon, but I hope that you have learned over the last few months so much more about what school truly is. It's a chance to learn with friends, to connect with your teachers. You've learned lessons about determination and motivation. You've also learned about frustration and disappointment. Those lessons are things that are going to stay with you, along with all of your other memories of Sayen that you have as you move on to middle school. Believe me, you are ready for middle school. You're ready for the big building and the different teachers. You're ready for the lockers and the having to change for gym. You're ready for it all. I want to give you a little bit of advice before you move on to middle school. First, remember, you are strong. You are going to be challenged, and that's okay. You can do it. Find that motivation and persevere. Do not let a roadblock become a permanent detour. Find another way around. You can do it. Find a friend, but don't forget to be a friend. Be a cheerleader, not a judge. Be the defensive line and not the tackle. You will be tempted at times to bring others down. Don't take the bait. Be the one that lifts another up, as you would want someone to do that for you. Learn from your mistakes. You are going to make them. Mistakes are the greatest teachers in life, even better than Mrs. Ballant and Mr. Leo. When you make a mistake, own it, admit to it, take your consequence, learn from it, and move on. My friends, this is your story. You have a chance to rewrite your ending each and every day. Just remember that your opening line is, "I am a Sayen Lion." My friends, your time at Sayen Elementary School has helped to grow that foundation for you. We've widened out your support system, and we are ready to let you continue to grow. But your foundation didn't start with us. It started at home. So what I want you to do right now is I want you to take a minute, and when I'm done giving you these instructions, you can pause the video if you need to. And I want you to turn to the people that are sitting with you. Tell them thank you. Thank you for always being there, for always being your biggest cheerleader, for supporting you, for loving you. I'll wait. Families, thank you so much for the support that you give to your children each and every day. We would not have made it through these last few months without your support. They are very lucky to have you. And to my fifth grade friends, we are going to miss you terribly. You are an extremely special group of kids, and I'm very sad that we did not get a chance to say our proper goodbye. But it is never goodbye. It is always just, "I'll see you later," because Sayen will forever be your home. Please be sure to come back and visit us as you continue on through middle school and beyond. And always remember, we're very proud of you.
Lewis Artman, Jackson Bischoff, Leia Cruz Estevez, Wyatt Kutchel, Grady Denson, Charles DiGiuseppe, Ava Ferdetta, Emily Frame, Taylor Gurman, Colin Gill, Kevin Contreras Gonzalez, Makai Green, Adriana Hedden, Brandon Kell, Abigail Curlin, Ariana Labou, John Lowe, Juliana Manto, David Malief, Derek Monahan, Danica Spack, Cassidy Spitzner, Diana Terichuk,
Diana Garcia, Charles McGowan, Ava Ricca, Zarif Ahmed, Kira Baker. Samuel Benzavengo. Mackenzie Bendis. Isabella Caniglio. Catherine Corby. Lily DiGiuseppe. Makai Gilliam. Irene Jackman. Joey Kovacs. Jaime LeVay Urzar. Liam McCormick. Rolando Menendez. Sydney Michael. Phoebe Moncada. Michael Polichuk. Gabriel Piano. Robert Quartermass. Michaela Smith. Alexis Toth. Rocco Valentino. Anthony Volpacella. Mitchell Whitman.
Boys and girls, this year was certainly a bummer. We had so much more to teach you, so many more memories to make, and so many more laughs to share together. Unfortunately, it just was not in the cards for us this year. Let's be honest for a second. It's unfair and it stings. However, let's not let our unfortunate ending tarnish our beginning and our middle. We laughed a lot, enjoyed every single day with all of you, and I hope you even learned a thing or two along the way. Remember, this year we made history together, and that's something that all of us will keep with us for many years to come.
Before we let you go, I hope you will allow us this one last opportunity to give you some advice to take with you to middle school.
Work hard.
Things won't always come easily to you, and guess what? They shouldn't.
What is worth learning is worth working hard for.
Don't let frustration get the best of you. Persevere, ask for help, and keep trying.
The payoff will be great.
Be humble.
Yes, you are smart.
Yes, you are talented. And yes, you are athletic.
You are a lot of great things.
But so are a lot of other people.
Be humble about your accomplishments and be quick to compliment others on theirs.
You will be respected and appreciated by others for this attitude.
Smile.
That one seems silly perhaps, but it is important.
Maintaining a positive attitude or faking it when necessary will go a long way towards helping you make new friends and feeling good about yourself.
You'll be amazed at how much better the world looks and how the world looks at you when you have a smile on your face.
Be courteous and respectful towards adults, towards your peers, towards yourself.
Good manners and a respectful attitude will take you far in this world.
Get involved.
Find extracurricular activities that you're interested in and get involved.
Don't worry if you are the only one of your group of friends interested in joining a particular club or activity.
If that activity interests you, go for it.
Better yet, be the leader.
Never fear standing alone.
Fifth graders, you leave here having learned a lot, but you have much more to learn in the years ahead. Be willing to learn from your teachers, your parents, your coaches, and your friends. Maintain a positive attitude, a helpful disposition, and a willingness to try new experiences. Keep reading, be kind, clean your room, practice your instrument, be good to each other, and finally, keep smiling.
I wish somebody would have told me, babe, someday these will be the good old days. All the love you won't forget, and all these reckless nights you won't regret. Someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of these good old days.
I was thinking about the band, I was thinking about the fans. We were underground, loading merch in that 12-passenger van. In a small club in Minnesota, and the snow outside of First Ave. I just wanted my name in the star. Now look at where we at, still growing up. Still growing up. was still young. Those good old days.
I wish somebody would have told me, babe, that someday these would be the good old days. All the love you won't forget, and all these reckless days.